Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. In this video, we're going to dive into everything you need to know about accounting for notes payable. Notes payable can be a significant account for companies, impacting their cash flow and overall financial health. So we definitely want to get a clear understanding of this concept. We'll start off with an overview of notes payable and make sure we're comfortable with the definition. Once we get an understanding of the concept, we'll move along into some common examples and finish things off by developing an understanding of how the accounting works, highlighting the implications to a company's financial statements along the way. We can think of notes payable as a formal legal contract with a commitment to pay out a sum of money at a point in the future.
You may have entered into an arrangement like this before when you purchased your own car.
If you've ever financed your vehicle instead of paying for it in full, then you've likely taken on the equivalent of a note payable. By signing the car paper financing, you committed to paying for the vehicle in the future at a predetermined rate. This would likely come in the form of monthly car payments.
The debt you would have taken on from this purchase would then be reported on your credit report.
The same goes for organizations that are entering into these types of contracts. As soon as they make a commitment to pay an amount in the future, it gets reported as a note payable on their balance sheet.
What this does is it allows users of the financial statements to become aware of their debt and make more informed decisions.
For reasons like this, companies are required to report all their future commitments under the liability section on the balance sheet. And notes payable are one of the key categories of liabilities. Consider a company that is looking to purchase a new delivery truck for $100,000. Now, if they don't have the cash readily available, they'll likely consider taking on the debt to make the purchase.
After considering their options, the CFO of the company decides to borrow the $100,000 from the bank.
The bank agrees to lend the money by asking the company to sign a contract or promissory note, which would include details around the maturity date, interest, and timing of payments. In our example, let's assume the bank requires the company to pay back the $100,000 loan over the next 5 years. The bank doesn't just lend out the money for free. So they include a 10% annual interest rate and require monthly payments. These are the key details that make up the note payable. As soon as the company signs the promissory agreement and receives the loan, an accounting transaction has occurred because money has changed hands and a financial commitment has been made. As a result, the company is required to reflect this in their financial statements. On their balance sheet, we would see a $100,000 increase to their cash on the asset side, and a corresponding $100,000 increase to their notes payable on the liabilities side. Now that we have a good understanding of the concept, let's run through a common misconception. There's a difference between notes payable and accounts payable. Many people confuse the two since they're both common types of liabilities. The major difference is that accounts payable are short-term obligations, usually made to suppliers that are made in the course of normal business operations. Say, for example, I run a construction business and you are my wood supplier. Since we have a great relationship, you decide to give me 60 days to pay for my supplies. The money I owe you would be considered a liability since a commitment has been made to pay you in the future. However, this type of liability would be considered an accounts payable. Typically, these types of business arrangements are less formal agreements than notes payable and don't usually include interest paid within the agreed upon timeframe. Now, this would flip from an accounts payable to a note payable in the event I decided to borrow all the money upfront from a bank instead. So let's look a little further at how we account for this type of note payable. If we build off the example from the construction company, let's say the bank lends my business $50,000 to be paid back in 2 years at an interest rate of 12% per year. I signed the contract and received the $50,000 on January 1st, of year one. Like we discussed earlier, this triggers an accounting transaction where we would record the increase to cash and increase to our notes payable liability with the journal entry that you're seeing on the screen. Now, if we fast forward to the year end December 31st financial reporting date, it's now time to make our first interest payment. We would calculate this by taking the original $50,000 loan and multiplying it by the 12% interest rate to get an annual interest payment of $6,000. This would result in an increase to our interest expense and a decrease to the cash account of $6,000. Lastly, We fast forward in time once again to the end of year two. At this point in time, not only do we have to pay another $6,000 to cover the interest for year two, but it's also now time to pay back the original $50,000 loan. We would do this by clearing out the notes payable balance by $50,000 since we no longer owe that money. And then we would decrease the cash balance to reflect that the money has been paid back to the bank. That sums up the key accounting transactions that would take place over this two-year time frame. And that brings us to the end of the video. Remember, notes payable are an extremely common category of liabilities for most companies. They allow organizations to access the capital they need in order to make investments that will give them the opportunity to grow and continue to operate in the future. For that reason, it's important that we understand how to account for them and how they impact the financials of the organization. If you're interested in learning more about financial accounting concepts like this, please feel free to check out our additional videos on Chegg for many more related topics.